In order to draw the shear force and bending moment diagram of an overhanging beam, including a triangular distributive loading, we can start by first figuring out the support reactions. To do that, let's draw our free body diagram. Here we have a pin support at point A, and that will have two support reactions, one going vertically upward, that's AY, and the other one will be the horizontal, given as AX. Next, I have a roller at point B that has only one support reactions in the vertical direction, given as BY. Next, we have a distributive loading, in this case, a triangular distributive loading. So converting that distributive loading into the point load, we have to know the area of the triangle, that is half times base times altitude. Here it is coming equals to 135 pounds. Now, this point load will be applied at the centroid of the triangle, that is two-thirds from the lower side of the triangle, equals to 6 feet. Finally, I have a couple moment of 180 pound fit applied at point C. Now, once we have drawn our free body diagram, let's go ahead and write our equilibrium equation. We can start with summation of forces along the x direction equals to zero. Since we have only one force, AX, in the x direction, its magnitude is equals to zero. Next, we can write summation of forces along the y direction equals to zero, taken upward as positive. Here, AY is going in the upward direction, so we will take that thing as positive, minus 135, that's the point load from the distributive loading, and plus BY. This gives us our first expression, and we will mark it as equation 1. Next, we can write our summation of moment, and we can do it at any point on the beam. Typically, we pick a point that has most number of unknowns so that they won't contribute into the moment expression. So summation of moment at point A equals to zero, taking counterclockwise as positive. Here we have our point load of 135 pounds that is making a moment arm of 6 with respect to point A. Since it is going in the clockwise direction, we will take it as negative. Next, we have our BY that have a moment arm of 9, producing a counterclockwise moment. And finally, I have a couple moment of negative 180 since it is going in the clockwise direction. Simplifying, we get the value of BY as 110 pounds. Now, we can go ahead and plug that thing into equation number 1 and solve for our AY, and that is coming as 25 pounds. Now, once we have our support reactions, let's go ahead and apply the method of sections. So in this problem, we have to make two sections because of the discontinuities present, as the distributive loading is only applicable from point A and B. So we may have to make a cut from in between point A and B. And next, we have to make a cut in between B and C to observe how the shear force and moment are changing. So let's start with our first section in between point A and B and draw our free body diagram. Here I have a support reaction at A having an upward force of 25 pounds. After that, we have a triangular distributive loading present here, and we have make a cut at a distance X. Now, whenever we make a cut, there will be the internal forces that will become exposed. In this case, we have three total internal forces. One is the normal in the horizontal direction, the other one is our shear force in the vertical direction, and then we have our couple moment given by variable M. Now, since we have made a cut in between point A and B, and so the value of X lies from 0 all the way to less than 9 feet. And since the value is less than 9, we are not including the force at our point B. Now, once we have the triangular loading, we don't know what will be the magnitude at the very top of the triangle since we have made a cut at an unknown distance. To figure out that value, we can utilize our similar triangle principle. Let's consider the bigger triangle having a base of 9 and a height of 30. Next, this triangle is similar to the smaller triangle as we have developed in our free body diagram, in which the base of the triangle is x and the altitude we have to calculate. Now, since both of them are similar triangles, the ratio of the sides of these triangles are equals to one another. Equating the two ratios, we can calculate the value of the height of our section triangle, that is coming 3.33x. Now, once we have the altitude of the triangle, we can now convert this distributive loading into the point load by calculating the area of this triangle, that is half times x times 3.33x. Now, once we have all the forces, let's go ahead and write our equilibrium equation of summation of forces in the vertical direction, taking upward as positive. Here, 25 pound is going in the upward direction, so taken as positive. Our point load going in downward direction, so negative half times x times 3.33x. And then we have finally our shear force going in the downward direction as negative V. This gives us our expression of shear force. Now, once we have our expression, we need to plug in the values of x at the two extremes and solve for our shear force. So once I plug in the value of x equals to 0, we are getting a shear force value of 25 pounds. And at the value of x equals to 9, we are getting our value of negative 110. Let's go ahead and plot these values on the diagram. Now, once we have the two extremes plotted, we still need to figure out how those Now, once we have the two extremes plotted, we still have to figure out the profile between these two points. Coming back to the equation, since I have a quadratic equation here, so my profile on the diagram will also be a quadratic profile. Now, one other important point to observe here is, since our shear force is transitioning from a positive value to a negative value, we need to identify where this transition is happening. That is known as point of inflection. It is one of the key points, because at this transition we have our maximum bending moment. So to identify this point, we can plug in the value of V equals to 0 in the same equation and solve for x. Next, we can go ahead and write our summation of moment equation at the section, so that our shear force V won't contribute into the moment expression. Here, we can start with 25 pound force that has a moment arm of x and making a clockwise moment. Next, I have this point load of half times x times 3.33x. Now, this load is acting at the centroid of the triangle, that is one third from the higher side. So the moment arm will be x over 3. Multiplying those will give us our moment value in the counterclockwise direction. Finally, I have a couple moment of m in the counterclockwise direction, so that will be added. Now, we have our moment expression. Let's go ahead and plug in the values of x at the extremes, and in addition, let's plug in the value at the point of inflection of 3.84, because at this point we will get our maximum value of moment. So at x equals to 0, the value of m is equals to 0. Whereas at x equals to 3.84, we are getting a value of 64.5 pound feet. Finally, at x equals to 9, we are getting a value of moment of negative 180 pound feet. Once we have the three values, let's go ahead and plot this thing on the diagram. So to start, we identify the points first at which we have calculated the value. So at x equals to 0, my moment is equals to 0. At x equals to 3.84, the moment value is 64.5. And at x equals to 9, I have a moment value of negative 180. Once we have these points identified, we have to identify the profile. Since I have a cubic equation, So my diagram will follow a cubic profile. So it is going at the highest point, that will be 64.5, as that is the point of inflection. And afterwards, the moment diagram starts going in the downward direction, going all the way to negative 180. Now, once we have the shear force and bending moment diagram for the beam section in between A and B, let's move to our second section in between B and C and create a cut. Once we have done that, let's go ahead and develop the free body diagram for that section. I have a point load at A in the upward direction of 25 pounds. I also have the complete distributive loading in this case, so I have a complete triangular loading. Next, I have a point load at B, that is the support reaction of the roller in the upward direction of 110 pounds. And since we have made a cut, the internal loads will become exposed, and we have three internal forces, our normal, our shear force V, and the couple moment M. Now, since we have made a cut at a distance that we are not aware of, so let's give it a variable x, and the value of x will lies in between our 9 feet and all the way to a value less than 13.5 feet. These are the extremes of the section in between B and C. Now, our distributive loading can be converted into a point load by taking the area of the triangle, that is 135 pounds, and that will be at the centroid of the triangle, that is 2/3 from the lower end of that triangle, as 6 feet. Once we have our free body diagram, we can go ahead and write our summation of forces in the vertical direction, our equilibrium equation, and equate it equals to 0. And if we simplify, we are getting a shear force value of 0, and that is constant throughout the whole section, as this is not dependent on the value of x. So we can go ahead and draw our shear force diagram, that the shear force will be equals to 0 throughout this section. Next, we can go ahead and write our summation of moment equation at the section, taking counterclockwise as positive, so that our shear force V won't contribute in the moment equation. We can start with that 25 pound load in the upward direction with a moment arm of X that will create a clockwise moment. Next, I have that point load of 35 pounds. Now, the distance between that to the section is X minus 6, and this will create our clockwise moment. Next, I have a support reaction at B of 110 pound that will create a clockwise moment, and having a moment arm of X minus 9. Finally, we have a couple moment M in the counterclockwise direction, that's why taken as positive. If we simplify this expression, we are getting a final value of M equals to negative 180. Now, in this case, since it is again a constant number and it doesn't depend on the value of x, so on the bending moment diagram, we will have our constant negative 180 pound fit throughout the whole section from B to C. Now, one final part, since I have a couple moment that is in the clockwise direction at point C, so at point C it will jump up from negative 180 all the way to 0,